And now we're joined by Commission on Higher Education, or CHED Chairman Prospero De Vera. Chairman De Vera, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen, and good morning for your very balanced introductory report. You know, I was surprised by the fake news and the insinuations that have been circulating. So I'd like to make clear, number one, K-12 is not abolished. And CHED has no authority to abolish senior high, because I have been getting reports complaining that I have abolished senior high school. That's not within the jurisdiction of CHED. Now, second, the CHED memo is not abrupt or arbitrary. We have been telling the state universities and colleges and LUCs for about 3 years now about the impending ending of the transition period. And many of them have actually closed their senior high. And there has been no displacement in these areas. Mm-hmm. It has been smooth. And the transition has been good. No, we are doing this every year. I am surprised that it is only my memo this year which has become controversial. This has been going for 3 years now. Some SOCs have ended their senior high as early as 2018 and 2019, no?
So why is that? It's, I mean, hearing from you right now, it's quite surprising that you have lawmakers. I mean, Gabriela Party List Representative Arlene Brosas, for example, is slamming CHED, and the description is for the abrupt decision of CHED, abrupt, to discontinue senior high school programs in government-run universities and colleges. Parang lumalabas, ngayon yun lang to na desisyonan. Parang nagising kayo at bigla na lang.
They should check in the regions. Maybe they should ask their supporters or their friends in the region to check. In Region 6, the state universities there, Iloilo Science and Technology University, NISU, the schools in Negros have ended their senior high. Philippine Normal University has ended it. So many other state universities and colleges have ended it. PhilSCA has ended it as early, I think, as 2018. This has been ongoing for 3 years now, because of the agreement between DepEd and CHED that the transition period is a period where state universities and colleges will assist. Because remember, when the K-12 law was passed, there was excess capacity on the part of the state universities and colleges.
Yes.
There was no incoming freshman. On the other hand, there was not enough rooms and teachers on the part of DepEd. That is the reason why there was an agreement during the transition period, that we will use the excess capacity of CHED for the students of senior high. That was supposed to have ended in 2021. We have been telling the universities, and they have been acting on it since 2019, actually. And so many have already closed their senior high without any dislocation at the local level. So I am surprised that CHED is now being accused of being arbitrary, of being whimsical in our decision making. They should check on the ground on the so many state universities and colleges who have closed their program. No? Because as I said, there is no more legal basis for it. The transition period is already over.
And do the state universities and colleges, do they themselves want to already abolish, so to speak, or not already do senior high school in SUCs?
It depends on the state universities and colleges. Some of them actually want senior high school because these are like feeder programs to their specialization. For example, our maritime schools want to experiment with the senior high curriculum that goes into maritime education. Mm-hmm. Our engineering schools want STEM programs so that they can, it becomes a feeder program for their courses. Yeah. But the problem is the enrollment in state universities and colleges have also dramatically increased. And therefore, they also need the facilities. They need the teachers for their own students. So you have to, there is a balancing act that has to be done in terms of accepting and being able to provide senior high. So it's, I hope there is no impression na parang nagdadamot yung mga state universities and colleges na ayaw nilang tanggapin. There are state universities and colleges, Karen, who have classes all the way until Saturday already because their enrollment has also increased dramatically because of free higher education. Yeah. And so you have to balance, balance these things, no? And so the transition period ended in 2021. The problem is there is no more legal basis to pay vouchers and no legal basis also for them to continue. And that's why we have been telling them slowly, please discuss this with your Board of Regents. Chet is not the one deciding on this. This is the Board of Regents of the state universities and colleges balancing all the concerns of the state universities and colleges because there are no more vouchers. There are costs involved in educating students and they need the facilities and teachers also.
Okay, very good. Now, quickly, I'm curious, no? So I know that tama ba ito, the budget for state universities and colleges, because it is now free. This was signed into law under the time of former President Duterte. Is the budget still at 8 billion pesos a year?
Reimbursement of tuition and miscellaneous fees
SUCs
are not fully paid by government. There is a big gap. Hindi bayad lahat ng estudyante nila. So that's the other issue that we must take up. Kulang na yung subsidy and then dadagdag ang senior high na wala ding subsidy dahil
So under the law, tanong ko, yung free SUCs chairman, yung unang budget doon was 8 billion. Tama ba yung memory ko? Was it 8?
No. You cannot allocate funding for senior high in the budget.
Not senior high. Yung SUCs lang. SUCs. Meaning freshman. Freshman college to up to. Let's say pumasok pa ng SUC, di ba? Libre yon. Yes. Magkano binudget ng gobyerno doon?
Depende yan doon sa tuition na chinacharge ng individual SUCs, no? Starting 2 years ago, hindi na dumadaan ng CHED yan. It is given directly now to them. So we're not involved in validating whether the claims of the SUCs are correct or not because it's now directly released to them.
Ang susunod na tanong, sino noon ang nagbabayad nung voucher system? Ito yung pinambabayad ng senior high school sa SUC. Saan ang gagaling yung pondong yun? DepEd.
Galing sa DepEd. They are being funded to the tune of a little over, I think, 7,000 per student. Subsidy by the Department of Education.
But then 7,000 a year? Or you mean what? Per semester?
A year na yun, a year.
Oh my gosh. But okay. All right. So, I mean, that voucher of 7,000 a year, that would be nothing even in an SUC, right? Pero go on.
Yes and no. Chet agreed to it because we want to help during the transition period. Kahit na medyo abunado yung mga public universities, okay na rin yan because there is excess capacity at that time. Because there was no senior high, there was no freshman for 2 years, and that gap moves to about 5 years overall. So it was okay to accept senior high students at that time. No, that's why there is a transition period. But the SOCs are operating at full capacity now. Some of them are even operating until Saturdays already. So they also need the facilities. No, plus the problem is there is no legal basis to give the money to SOCs anymore. So mahirap naman natatanggap yung state universities. Tapos wala namang subsidy. Mahirap naman.
Okay. All right. So my last question is, do you have the number of, I know that this isn't CHED's purview, but would you have the number with you of how many are incoming senior high school for this year?
That's why my memorandum was to the state universities and colleges. Kasi iba-iba, depende yan sa carrying capacity ng mga state universities and colleges. That's why my memo is not to stop senior high. It is to tell the SOCs to discuss it in their Board of Regents so that they can make the appropriate action on it given the fact that there is no more subsidy, that they also need the facilities themselves. And it is up to them to decide kasi iba-iba yung situation across the country. Yeah.
But I think in the end here, the truth is, DepEd is, itama ba itong pagkakaintindi ko? They're no longer giving vouchers to senior high schools for SOCs. Yun lang yun. Tama?
They're giving vouchers this school year only to grade 12.
Oo, yung grade 12 na yon, that's senior high school.
That's the the second year of senior high school. Wala nang po grade 11 kasi nga tapos na yung transition period. There is also no more, you know, and DepEd also has their own high schools already to carry the students.
Uh-oh.
That's why
yung voucher na ibinibigay ng DepEd for grade 12, saan lang po pwede gamitin yon ngayon? Hindi na sa SUCs, pwede lang
pwede
gamitin
pa.
Yun.
Pwede pa. Yun. Oh, pwede pa. Pero one year na lang. Kaya yung maraming SOCs hindi na nagtanggap ng grade 11.
Kasi pero may grade 12.
Natin. Meron. Kaya yung...
bakit nagpapanik? Oo, meron pa.
I don't really know where the accusations that there is arbitrariness is coming up because there is grade 11 and 12 in many SOCs and the SOCs are subsidizing the grade 11 even if there is no voucher. The others are subsidizing or have stopped accepting grade 11. They continue with their grade 12. That is the situation on the ground. That is the basis of the memorandum so that they can now take stock of what they're doing, look at the financial implications of this, look at their own carrying capacity and their enrollment, and decide. Mm-hmm. It is not CHED who will decide. It is with the state universities and colleges and local universities and colleges.
But do you think this is a miscommunication issue? Because in all the articles, when it says senior high school, I think many people see that as only grade 12. Right now, what you are explaining, just to be specific, is the memorandum is SUCs will no longer take grade 11, but yung current grade 12 na may voucher pa from DepEd, SUCs can still take them.
No, I did not tell them that they should stop taking in grade 11. I am saying you now review your grade 11 and 12 because there's no more subsidy coming from the national government and you decide how you will close it. So some of the schools still accepted grade 11. They are subsidizing it using their own funds because grade 12 lang ang may funding. Yung iba naman, hindi na nagtanggap ng grade 11. That is what is happening on the ground. And these are decisions to be made by individual schools, taking into consideration their own needs because they also have students who need the facilities, the funding that they have, etc. That is what the memo contains. Yeah.
But is that the memo or is your memo, just quick na to, last December 18 is directing the SUCs and LUCs to discontinue? Kasi what you're telling me now is your memo is you decide kung kaya nyo. Pero the memo that's been spreading is you are ordering them to discontinue. Ano po ba talaga?
The memo says that the transition period is already over.
Okay.
And therefore, the DepEd has issued a notice that there will be no more subsidy for the students. And therefore, they have to discontinue their senior high school because there is no more legal basis. When you say discontinue, they will slowly close it. When discontinue, it doesn't mean they will stop accepting students. So if you have grade 12, for example, the board will have to decide, pag-graduate na lang yung grade 12. Kung may grade 11, they will have to say, how will they fund the grade 11 given the fact that there is no more subsidy coming from government? Yes. That is the content of the memo.
Okay. All right. Well, sir, we don't have enough time, but I do hope to speak with you again regarding this issue. I mean, in the coming days. I want to thank you so much, Ched Chairman Popoy de Vera, for joining me today. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Karen.